Come in, please. Ta-da, she says. Oh my, says Rozet. What the... Halt Mayor says. Aren't we supposed to say ta-da? Huh? Says Ada. You aren't as surprised as I thought you would be. Am I missing something here? Oh, Max, says Rozet. Long time no see, Rozet. Mayor Holsto, too. You look good. Since Riotam Island, huh? Holsto says, Mr. McBean, thank you again for what you did then. And Rozet says, I heard from Mayor, so I knew you would someday come here on a tour. But it's so good to see you. Has it been 10 years or so? Yeah, something like that, says McBean. Let me introduce them. This is my grandson Forte, and his childhood friend Una. We are performing together as the McBean Company. I'm Forte. How do you do? Hello, I'm Una. Hi, welcome, says Rozet. You're going on a tour with your grandson, huh? I feel like both you and I have aged. At any rate, I didn't even imagine that you would come home with Mac, Ada. Ada says, the wood soldiers appeared in Marcha, and the people there doubted that they were made in our factory. Then, Mr. Mac came by and dispelled the misconception by telling them that they should be made from the ancient cedars if they were made at our factory. What? Says Rozet. I can't believe anyone would say such a thing about our factory. The mayor says, well, you can't blame them. The people in Ekyul know you, so they would not doubt you, but... Outsiders would suspect this place first thing. Humph. By the way, says the mayor, I wonder who set those wood soldiers free. Must be the Numerous Empire, says McBean. Really? Says the mayor. McBean told him about the incident in Gavaro. Oh my, says Rozet. The mayor says, the classified weapons, huh? It's disturbing. Rozet says, I don't know who is abusing the technology of making wood soldiers. He doesn't even deserve to be called a puppet master. Definitely, says McBean. I bet it's maddening to you since you've been devoting yourself to the puppet making, Rozet. What is that? That's my masterpiece, Capuri the Puppet. You still haven't lost your edge. The mayor says, I heard that he finally completed this. So, I just came here to see it. Then, he told me that Ada had gone for errands. I decided to wait till she came back because I just wanted to see her handle it. Rozet is the master of marionette making. Ada is better at handling the marionette. Really? Says Forte. Oh yeah, she's a true master. Ahem, she says. Rozet says, Everyone's is waiting. Rozet says, well, why don't you show them how you handle the puppet? Okay. Ada put on leather gloves. Clear strings extended from the fingertips of the gloves and connected to the marionette. She coughs. Hello, Capuri. Capuri, I don't know what kind of voice this would be. Hello, Ada. It talked? Says Forte. Mayor says, Ada is using ventriloquism. Oh, she is. How's it going, Capuri? She says. Couldn't be better. How about you, Ada? Me? I'm as fine as a summer sun. Always happy-go-lucky, Capuri kinda says. Yeah, always happy. Hey, I'm not happy-go-lucky. That's no way to treat a lady. Lady? Where? Where? Humph, whatever. Anyway, can you do me a favor? Can you show your power to everyone? Piece of cake. Thanks, Capuri. Capuri, destroy the rock. Easy. What? Hey, Ada says. Just joking, Capuri sort of says. Be serious. I'm serious this time. Wow, says McBean. It looks like Grandpa, says Forte. Did you see that? Ada says. Did you see that? Capuri says. McBain says, it's got great destructive power. Hmm, Rozet says. Ada, that's enough for the unveiling ceremony. Take it to the workshop, please. Okay. Oh, down there? Mac, says Rozet. Don't take it wrong. I didn't create Capuri for fighting. After having devoted myself to making it, I was just able to create a sturdy puppet, that's all. Besides, the reason why Capuri is strong is because Ada is handling it. Anyone else wouldn't do as good as Ada. I know, says McBain. Rozet says, thanks. Mayor says, Ada, you're an awesome marionette master. I bet you will make a good troubadour as well with the same team as Mr. McBain. Do you think so? Thank you, says the mayor. It was fun. Well, I gotta get going. Mr. McBain, please stop by at my house later. Where's your house? Wait, where's your house? Oh, right, with the lady. She was there by herself. Now he'll be there with her. Rozet says, can you stay here a little, right? Yeah, I've been looking for something. Until I have it, I'll stay here. Looking for something? McBain opens the magic map. Okay. Alright, so there's Ekyul, Rozet's workshop. Hermit's Serenade. Giraffe. Shayla Road, checkpoint. Grim Bridge. Another checkpoint. Yellow Sand Way. Oasis. Selbart. What's to the south? Enid. Alright, so he's looking for this. Which I can't really go on, but it's by Mardrin Road. North of Giraffe. So we're here. Oh, so it's south of us, but north of Giraffe. Huh. What is it? A treasure map? Something like that. We're looking for resonance stones which the musician named Leon hid all over the world. It looks like there's one here. Let me see, says Rozet. It looks like it's near the Wind Cave. Wind Cave, says Forte. If you go down south from Ekyul, you'll hit the ocean. There's a lighthouse called the Tower of Giraffe on the Cape. And inside of the peninsula around that area, encroachments made by the wind have created a cave. The wind can make a cave, huh? Says Forte. Rozet says, but it will take an unbelievably long time, though. Treasure hunting, huh? Sounds interesting, says Ada. You're too old for treasure hunting, says Rozet. Ha ha ha, you'll have to tell me that, says McBain. McBain put magic map inside his pocket. If you have any questions about this area, ask me, says Rozet. I'll cooperate with you as much as I can. Oh, Ada left the party? It's been a long time since you came to Ekyul last time, so stay and relax here for a while. Treasure hunting, huh? Sounds fun, but you're staying here. Okay. Hello? A book. I must have it. Give me the book. Never mind. The door is locked. Look at that little yard on the side. Little pendant area. Oh, they move. You see anything different now? Nope. I don't say anything new. Oh yeah, just gonna look around. Ooh! That's why we look around. Orb of Ocean 56. A marvel with the image of Ada smiling. Well, don't go that way. Wait, we came from down here, right? What's across this bridge? Oh, that's where we were with the rock. Something shined between the cracked rocks. Huh? What was that? Says Forte. Forte received a ruby. Okay, cool. It's just another thing to sell to vendors, right? Has a deep red color like blood. Ooh. Oh no, not one of these tuning fork thingies. I'd like to rest first, but we have to go back to town to do that. Which I guess we might as well do, because there's nothing else to do here. Forte says, Ada is so energetic. I wonder if she's always jumping and running like that. She's brisk in her speech and very cute, says Una. I don't know what to say, but she's very charming. McVeigh says, it's amazing how good she can handle the marionettes. I've never seen anyone as good as her who can handle the marionettes. She's skillful at that age. Well, we should get going and look for a resonance stone. Grandpa, looking for a resonance stone is important. But what do you think about performing here, since we are in Ekyul? Sounds good, says Una. What do you think, Grandpa? Ekyul is not as powerful as Kavaro, but this is a cool city with beautiful waterways. McVeigh says, okay, let's look around the city and check out what the city is like. We've already done that. Oop. The hell was that? Passing man says, wow, it's been a long time. Hey, Dad, don't get too excited, says passing woman. Jan is barking. What's wrong, Jan? Says Una. They ran up this way. Okay, I don't know who that was. It was so quick. Was that, those two that we keep running into, Rachel and Xiao? They kind of look like Rachel. I didn't get a good look at the other one. Are they looking around again? Do they say new stuff? Oh, that's the mayor! Alright, let's talk to the wife again. Grandma Kroto of Marcha is a wonderful craftswoman who spins a yarn. The yarn she makes is not only strong, but also colorful, so she gets many customers from the other countries too. I also buy yarns for sewing from Ms. Kroto. Mrs. Kroto. The mayor himself. Kavaro is still completely blockaded by the numerous soldiers. I wonder if they're going to extend their attack to Ekyul, too. Mr. McVeigh, is there anything we can do to prepare in advance? Why do you ask me? You look like you've got more experience in this kind of situation. Grandpa, you're cold. McVeigh says, but all I can say now is that you should lock the door since we don't even know if they're coming for sure. Lock the doors, huh? Says the mayor. Una says, look, he's taking notes. I feel uneasy when I think of the numerous soldiers being on the Ekyul side. As well you should. That's not the way out. Are we talking to everyone again? Because I gotta say all new stuff? Oh yeah, they're all saying new stuff. Quarks says, have you seen the Grim Bridge? The checkpoint of Grim Bridge is in the west is the biggest building in the world. The biggest in the world, says Forte? Well, we knew about two other worlds, so you might be wrong. Wow, it sounds awesome, says Una. Yeah, it sure looks spectacular, McBain says. What do you mean it looks spec- we're not looking at it. It's built of stones, but its length is a few hundred milos from one edge to another. I believe the Grim Bridge is the biggest thing ever built by humans. You don't say. I wonder if Ada is coming today. She doesn't have to, but she can if she wants to. Actually, my brother likes Ada very much. It's so obvious. Yeah. Not surprised. Cedars are fundamentally soft, but ancient cedars have a fine grain and are sturdy. If you cut and process them, they get dry. Then they turn very hard, so they are suited for crafts. Also, there's a legend that the forest spirit dwells in the ancient cedars. Anyway, they're a special blessing from the forests. The wood soldiers are carrying out the rampage to the east of the road lately. I need to tell my daughter not to go outside Ekyul. I'll tell her. Ada's Mr. Capri is cool, too. It can dance and talk. Mr. Bang Bang, you need to learn to speak, too. She's throwing her voice, or trying to do ventriloquism. Hello! See? Oh yeah, says Forte. Hello! Hello! Alright, item shop. We find a weapon shop, we can sell that gem. Locked. Oh, will he buy a gem? I think they buy anything, right? I'm thinking of Daggerfall, we don't buy stuff. That's nice, 1,000 gents. Still not enough to get another. I'm not selling that. Looks like the tarp thing is the most expensive thing we have. I'm not even looking at the items, I'm just looking at the price. Yeah, that's the most expensive thing. Can't part with anything else. Have to kill some monsters. I could go back to Ostern since I can make pretty good money, but I could earn more if I went to Kavaro. I want to do business in Kavaro no matter what. The Meritos group has a reputation for generosity. I hope the Numeros will retreat soon. Yes, but for your own selfish reasons, isn't that right? Fuzz Buzz and Kavaro. What? Is that what you call hubbub? Fuzz Buzz and Kavaro is not over yet? We don't have any customers coming from there at all. It's affecting my business a lot. Couldn't move there. The rumor says that the numerous soldiers are advancing on Kavaro, but it is as peaceful as usual here. Yep, for now. You gotta add that. For now. There's no one in these rooms. find this kid in the middle here. If he's still there. Yeah. Oh, the Balkas, the fisherman. No, I'm not from Ekyul. I come from the village named Giraffe in the south. It's a relaxing village along the coastline. I take pride in the big lighthouse there. Really? Says Forte. It's the same as my hometown, Rekos Palma. Really? Where is Rekos Palma, anyway? It's the very edge of Leteratudo. You came all the way from afar. We are going further. How far are you going? I don't know. Una says, probably we are going around Weltluna, so we're going to cross the ocean from Ostern and also go to Numerus and Burrardine. Yeah, that's cool. I'm jealous that you can travel that far at a young age. I've never gone farther than Cavaro. Making travel a job is pretty hard at times. But I envy you because I have lived my whole life in the place I was born. Mm-hmm. Checkpoint. Yeah, Quarks again. Imagine going around with a name like Quarks. Everybody would be telling you to put a cork in it whenever you talk. It'd be a sad deal. So wait, we're supposed to go to Giraffe next? I'm wondering if there are giraffes there. I don't want to leave. A giraffe is south. Oops. I think I've gone to all the places. In here. So that way is the checkpoint. What if we try to go this way? Oh, to let us. Shayla Road. I am shocked that it will let us. What a farce. It will let us go either way. Wow. This is anarchy. Complete anarchy. Where's that? I talked to that trader, right? The desert trader? I want to make sure that I've talked to... That's the weapon shop. That I've talked to them again. Or that... Him. Yeah, okay. Nothing to say. Nothing to do. Supposed to be getting one of those books from him, just so you know. It's the only part of the game that's not blind, just so I can not miss the books. Everything else is... I have no idea. I just know where some of the books are, and I... kind of look at them as I go. Like, okay, where's the next few books? So, what's past the checkpoint? Oh, okay, Grim Bridge. I forget to go check out the checkpoint. Would that be a stupid thing to do? Just surprised it's letting us go there. I'm wondering if it's like an optional thing. monsters are still afraid. Bunch of scaredy cats. Okay. Well, this is a jaunty little jig. All right, we need to kill stuff, don't we? I'll do it on the way back. We just need some money. I hope these things give out a good amount of money. I don't like grinding, but I want those items. Is that one sleeping? Oh. I don't remember ever hearing this song go this far. Alright, that leaves the map to the north. But there's a way or two that we have not gone, so we see what's over there. Did I see something interesting over there? Never mind. Thought I saw something in the corner of the screen. Like a different color. Right, okay, this... okay. There's no other way. There is no other way. Other than to giraffe, of course. They're probably gonna say they can't let us through the checkpoint yet. We need something, which we probably have to get in giraffe. Okay, what's up there? But we got stuff over here. Maybe. Checkpoint's here, but there's a way we haven't gone. So make sure we don't miss a chest or something. Completely nothing here, okay. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. I missed my little turn here. This way. I haven't saved for like over an hour, so... saving time. My, very impressive. Hi. Phew, hot. You feel hotter because of the fire, says Forte. You may be thinking it's not necessary to have bale fires even though it's this hot, but this bale fire is a talisman against the monsters. Most of the monsters don't like the fire. That's why they build the bale fires at the fortresses and checkpoints. Come to think of it, because the numerous soldiers are heavily equipped, there's no way they can bear this heat. Once the battle starts, we may have a chance to win. Okay. Okay. Very interesting. And some wood for the fires. I like that. They call them bale fires. Pretty cool. They're probably not going to let us through the checkpoint. So that's the way you would talk to them, and we got some sacks of something. There are many offices and such inside. Oh, look at that. It's broken over here. We can just fall off. What a hazard. Just looking for a lawsuit, aren't you? The rumor says that there's something suspicious going on with the Numerous Empire. You spelled it wrong. You spelled it as numerous. Also, they say that Commander Xenon of a radical group is cleaning up the officials of moderate function. How barbaric they are. I'm so glad I was born in Marcheros. What? That Xenon guy came to Cavaro? Are you serious? I don't want the people from the barbaric country to come here. The people in Marcheros love peace. We dress like soldiers, but there are only self-defense guardsmen. Once the battle starts, we'll be in trouble. Hello? I heard the Cavaro was attacked by the wood soldiers. The Numerous saved the city, but it's too bad that Cavaro made a debt to Numerous. No. The traveler says, it's tough to be a guardsman. They have to worry about not only the monsters, but also the Numerous army. I assume this is a checkpoint where we have to be let past, right? Maybe at the end, the exit. Oh, this just goes out. Ah, they have new stuff. Sworder sword? It's more sword than sword. Long sword with a slim single-edged blade. Master it and you're a full-fledged sworder. 3,400 gold. We need a lot more money. Blue dragon spear? Well, Ada's not even with us right now. Spear with a curved single-edged tip for sweeping rather than piercing. So a thunder bow for Una. So we're gonna never mind the sniper bow and just get her the thunder bow when we have enough money. Bow with a very thick hemp string makes a thunderous sound as arrow is released. Roaring glove. Glove made of monster hide can inflict great damage without hurting knuckles. Sword or shield. Shield with many blades designed for breaking or stealing the enemy's swords. Really? And Forte's defense will go up by 2. Sworder armor. Armor with metal reinforced cotton lining looks just like ordinary clothes. So is that his defense will go up by 6. Okay, I got the sworder armor now then, since I can. And do we have enough for the shield? Not quite, but once we sell the other one back, we will. Forte is the only one with this extra shield ability. Okay, sword or armor defense up by 6, unless We want to give the other armor to somewhere else. But that would mean we can't get the shield yet. Ring armor. McBain was up by 2. She still has that avoidance. That avoidance decrease. So I'll give the ring armor to McBain. And we'll sell the other armor. Whatever it's called. The air armor. Was I gonna get the shield, right? $440, yeah. Sword or shield, defense up by 2. To a total of 99. We can sell the kite shield. And now we don't have a lot of money. It's all the same stuff we already have. That's it. That's it for the checkpoint. Ahead of us is the Grim Bridge. After passing the bridge, it's Ostern. Are you leaving Marcharose? No, I'm just here to take a look, says Forte. Well, we'll come back soon to cross the bridge. I'll see you then. The Grim Bridge is admirable. The height of it is 102 milos, the highest in the world. Moreover, it's not only a bridge, but also acts as a dam to stop the water. And the artificial lake on the north is also beautiful. It's a must-see. Alright. We can't go. That's what I thought. I'm gonna hunt some monsters out here. Maybe make it an optional episode. Grinding. Grinding for weapons and armor. Or grinding for money, which will then become weapons and armor. Or we can turn the money into weapons and armor. Anyway, I thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned next episode for optional episode, cash grinding episode. And, yeah, I guess overlevel us a little bit more. Which is... Monsters avoid us, but now we need money, so we're gonna have to kill the unwilling monsters. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.